old man, Vinnie Mac. Yeah, blood. Mr. McMahon, the official trailer of the rise and fall of Vincent Kennedy McMahon. God damn it. Yeah. Hey, man. You pussies, blood. You call it rise and fall. I don't know about that, man. Some false pretenses in this documentary, because I remember this was getting filmed before there was the lawsuit talk, and obviously Vince is in the documentary, so they've obviously added on the lawsuit part at the end, but I guess it does make for compelling viewing, and also it would be a bit weird to leave it out considering what's gone on. But I maintain to this day, I don't know what Vince done illegal. Do I think that Vince probably done some weird acts? Yeah, I think he probably did. If you go judge by what you see on the TV screen, some of that stuff, you know what I mean? The women and all that. But that's between him and Linda. Was the adultery and all that business? Yeah, that seemed like it's common knowledge. Did Linda know? Yeah, seemed like common knowledge. Everything else I don't know. But I'm a documentary fiend. And I love them and I want to see how it's filmed. Hopefully it's compelling. Hopefully it's not just a hit piece and we do get like Austin and John Cena, and it's probably gonna have Hulk Hogan and Bischoff or someone like that. But I've spoken enough. Let's get it. I might post this on Hugo Online, might post it on Savage Thoughts Wrestling. You guys will see. It's gonna get copyrighted anyway, so just like the video. Here we go.
People wondered who I really am. You know, portrayal of me, I'm a bad guy.
Jesus!
No one really knows me. In the world of professional wrestling,
Vince McMahon,
he's easy to hate.
Oh, same people as him.
You expect Donald Fifer. That's exactly what you're gonna get.
Okay, first of all, I don't wanna keep pausing it yet, but I will if I need to. You can tell that there was a stop start in this recording instantly. Because when he first walks into the ring, he's fresh faced Vince. It feels like they probably started recording that around like WrestleMania when Cody first came in, when he fought Seth. The other one, he's got the darker eyebrows and it looks like he's trying to maintain himself. I'm guessing by the end of this he's gonna have the weird old man porn star thing he's got going on now. You know, like the French, I don't even want to say it because it's going to make him look worse. Let's get it.
It's not my fault that I happen to be a self-made billionaire.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to All American Wrestling.
When I bought my dad's business, my vision was to make this mainstream.
Welcome to WrestleMania.
Vince created this huge empire, billion-dollar entertainment juggernaut.
I'm a billionaire, goddammit. I'm Vincent Kennedy McMahon.
There were so many scandals going on.
Oh, shit.
For steroids.
90% of the wrestlers are on steroids.
Another dead wrestler.
This oh.
Rocked the very foundation.
Something weird, bruv. So this week, on Impulsive, we heard Hulk Hogan speak about who shall not be named, and I'm not talking about Voldemort. He said, if the wrestling fans can forgive CB, they can forgive me. First of all, I don't even know why you would compare yourself to CB. He's done way worse than what you've done. Second of all, no Hogan. That's not what's going on. And third, now he's in the Netflix documentary. In the same screen as Cena and Bischoff and Austin. We don't talk about him. The rabid Wolverine, we don't talk about him. Oh my God, six episodes of this. You know I'm gonna be there. You know I'm gonna review every single episode. All right, let's go.
WWE, I would accept no responsibility whatsoever.
None whatsoever.
None.
Breaking news, Vince McMahon is stepping aside.
The lawsuit accusing him of countless depraved and humiliating acts.
I didn't think the lawsuit could shock me, and I was floored.
Yeah.
When it comes to Vince, a lot of that as a character, he's going to show you what he wants you to see.
They put the son-in-law in there. I understand, we're going to speak after this.
The lines of reality are very blurred in our business.
You said it, Vince.
The individual loses all sense of who they really are.
My name is not Vince.
My name is Mr. McMahon. Come on. This was This was my creation. And if it's infested like a cancer, and if anyone's gonna kill it, it's gonna be me. I'm gonna kill it. Me. And the N.W. Sorry. Anyway, from the trailer, it didn't look like a hit piece. It looks like a compelling documentary. They're obviously going to go through 6 episodes. They're probably going to split up between his life. The first part's going to look very positive, starting off with the relationship between him and his dad and buying the company. It's going to slowly start morphing into what he did to the rest of the companies, to the rest of the territories, by brushing them aside and bringing wrestling into one place. Going to go slowly into WCW, going to hit the Attitude Era, and then the steroid scandals and all that stuff around the 80s and 90s and the doctors. And then slowly in the last 3 episodes, it's going to take a nosedive. And then, yeah, the last episode is going to make the customer, the viewer, make up their own mind on, is he a madman or is he a genius? Or do you have to be a madman to be a genius? Who knows? Who knows? I'd just like to say, I'm not sticking up to any guy that's been doing any weird, mad acts what are illegal. That's up to you and the law. I don't stand by it at all. But as a wrestling fan, I mean, I don't think I wouldn't have a wrestling channel. I wouldn't have been viewing wrestling if it weren't for Vince McMahon. But obviously, what he does in his private life, 2 different things. So we're going to have to see where it goes there. But I do think what I was trying to mention when I saw Triple H in it, what I was trying to get at is, this is a masterstroke plan from Netflix, adding on the lawsuit stuff at the end, simply because what they're going to do is, I can almost guarantee episode 6, you're going to hit about half an hour left and they're going to start talking about TKO and The Rock and Endeavor and all this stuff and how Triple H has taken over and Stephanie's there to back his case and the McMahon name's technically still there but not there, and it's the Paul Levesque era and this is nothing to do with Vince McMahon anymore. And I know, because they want to distance themselves from Vince McMahon, so doing a documentary on Netflix is fine. They do documentaries about everybody, the worst people, Dharma, all of those kind of, Bundy, all of that. But because Netflix are literally taking on WWE, $5 billion contract, they're going to need to distance themselves. I don't think people actually care. I don't think anyone will turn away from watching WWE on Netflix because they think that Vince slightly might have something to do with it. Nobody cares. It's just fake outrage. But this looks damn interesting. Maybe over the time, depending on how they drop the episodes, hopefully they drop 1 episode a week. If they drop it all together, I'm probably just going to have to watch the whole thing and then do a review, because I would like to do an episode at a time, but everyone's going to start putting spoilers out. All the journalists are going to start quoting stuff from it. It's going to ruin it for me. So let me know what you guys think in the comment section. Yeah, man, it's interesting. I'm probably going to put this on both channels just to make sure both audiences get it. But I've been your boy, Savage. Comment, like, subscribe, and share. Let me know what you all think of this documentary. I'm a billionaire, goddammit. Run.